Exciting news for everyone receiving Social Security, SSI, SSDI, and VA benefits. This Friday, $2,200 will be deposited into your bank accounts. In this video, we'll go over everything you need to know to make sure you're prepared and informed. We'll explain who qualifies for this $2,200 deposit and what criteria need to be met, how to check if you qualify, find out how to verify if you are eligible for this deposit, and the steps to take to confirm your status. What to do if you don't see the money in your account? Sometimes, things don't go as planned. We'll guide you on what to do if the deposit doesn't show up in your bank account on Friday. Key dates and timelines. Learn about important dates related to this deposit and what you should be aware of in the coming days. Frequently asked questions, FAQs, will answer some of the most common questions about this deposit to help clear up any confusion. After months of waiting and frustrating delays, millions of Americans relying on vital federal benefits are finally about to receive a massive financial lifeline. This Friday, direct deposits of $2,200 will start going out to recipients of Social Security, Supplemental Security Income, SSI, Social Security Disability Insurance, SSDI, and Veterans Affairs, VA, benefits. These emergency payments were authorized as part of the $1.90 trillion emergency relief package passed by Congress back in March. With so many struggling to pay for basic necessities like food, housing, and medical care amid the COVID-19 pandemic's economic fallout, these $2,200 deposits represent a critical backstop against poverty and despair for some of the most vulnerable segments of society. Tens of millions of Americans are scheduled to receive these payments over the coming weeks. This includes around 64 million Social Security beneficiaries, 8 million SSI recipients, 9 million SSDI beneficiaries, and over 5 million veterans receiving VA benefits. The vast majority will receive the full $2,200 payment automatically, though there are some eligibility rules around income thresholds. For Social Security, SSDI, and SSI, individuals with an adjusted gross income of $75,000 or less in 2022 qualify for the full amount, as do couples filing jointly with income under $150,000. Beyond those upper income limits, the $2,200 payment begins phasing out by $100 for every additional $1,000 in adjusted gross income. VA beneficiaries who received disability compensation, a pension, or were enrolled in certain low-income programs in 2022 qualify for the full payment regardless of income level. According to the latest updates from federal agencies, the first wave of deposits is expected to reach an estimated 30 million Social Security and SSI beneficiaries this Friday, May 31 stone, with millions more payments arriving over the first 2 weeks of June. SSDI and VA payment dispersals will likely start a bit later and stretch well into the second half of the month. For most, the money will arrive via the same direct deposit information already on file with the government agencies. Those without direct deposit set up will receive paper checks in the mail, which could take a few additional weeks. The original emergency relief bill envisioned these payments being distributed back in April, providing faster relief during the public health crisis. However, substantial logistical and operational hurdles within the various federal agencies ultimately caused the delays in getting the money out the door. Social Security, the IRS, and the Department of Veteran Affairs all faced immense challenges in updating payment files, verifying eligibility, calculating adjusted amounts for higher-income households, and setting up the distribution pipeline for over 86 million individual payments. VA officials in particular cited severe limitations with their antiquated information technology systems that needed emergency upgrades and modifications. The Biden administration pushed hard to accelerate the timeline, even deploying military computer personnel to the civilian agencies for support. But in the end, the operational lift proved too enormous to turn around in just a few weeks while ensuring accurate and complete payments to tens of millions of vulnerable Americans. While I know there's no substitute for a family missing a rent payment or unable to put food on the table, the American people can be assured these $2,200 payments will get into the hands of those in need, President Biden stated. We're making it a top priority to get it right the first time and avoid any widespread errors or improper payments. Of course, the delayed timeline opened a fierce partisan debate, with Republicans blasting the Biden administration for sheer incompetence in failing to deliver critical aid more expeditiously during the pandemic. Democrats countered that an undertaking of this massive scale, touching over 86 million recipients across multiple agencies, was inevitably going to face complex technical and operational hurdles that couldn't be resolved overnight. The partisan back and forth threatened to undermine public confidence, while also sparking calls for upgrades to the severely outdated payment infrastructure and IT systems at agencies like the IRS, Social Security Administration, and VA. With future rounds of direct payments likely needed to provide financial relief during economic shocks, modernizing this pivotal crisis response capability should be a priority, experts argued. While $2,200 is not a life-altering amount for many Americans, for the tens of millions of low-income seniors, disabled individuals, and veterans awaiting these payments, the money represents a critical lifeline after months of dwindling savings and soaring costs of living. Mary Jennings, a 74-year-old who survives on around $1,600 a month in Social Security and disability benefits to support herself and her disabled son in Akron, Ohio, explained how the payment will allow them to pay outstanding bills, afford several months of medications, and restock their bare pantry after rationing meals of inexpensive starches and beans. "Just that little bit extra is going to help me and so many others stay afloat and stop living off credit cards for basics," said Jennings. Millions of similar households running through meager nest eggs and maxing out credit lines see this money as a make-or-break factor in avoiding dire financial hardship in the coming months. According to economic analysts, the $2,200 payments are projected to help raise about 3.3 million Americans out of poverty, including nearly 1 million children. Studies show that direct payments to low-income households have an outsized impact, with recipients quickly spending the funds on goods, services, and paying down debt, providing an immediate stimulus jolt to the economy. "For every dollar going out in these payments, you're likely to see a return of about $1.50 in economic activity as it flows through local businesses and communities," said Mark Zondi, chief economist at Moody's Analytics. Overall, the payments are expected to increase consumer spending by around $49 billion in the second quarter and give GDP growth in that period a 0.3 percentage point boost. While provisions like the expanded child tax credit in the original $1.9 trillion relief bill garnered more attention for their poverty reduction effects, this emergency $2,200 payment is also critically important for the financial well-being of millions. As the pandemic's economic scars linger, the money provides a financial band-aid for those living paycheck to paycheck. Of course, the one-time payments are just a temporary stopgap. Anti-poverty advocates argue that more lasting solutions are still needed to boost the longer-term economic security of seniors, the disabled community, and low-income veterans through programmatic changes and increased benefits. While administration officials tout the deposits as providing a hugely impactful form of temporary relief to financially vulnerable households, critics argue it's an inefficient, blunt instrument that fails to address more systemic economic issues. "Throwing money haphazardly at the problem without broader reforms is like bailing out a sinking ship with a bucket instead of fixing the hole in the hull," said Brian Riedel, a budget analyst at the conservative Manhattan Institute think tank. "These one-off payments create the mirage of helping when in reality they're just kicking the can down the road at tremendous cost to taxpayers." Riedel and others point out that each round of these stimulus-style deposits adds substantially to the federal deficit at a time when concerns are rising over the nation's $31 trillion debt load. The $1.9 trillion relief bill that funded this latest $2,200 payment alone will cost the government around $350 billion just in interest payments, they argue. From a fiscal responsibility perspective, critics contend it would be wiser policy to instead pursue longer-term reforms aimed at boosting self-sufficiency and economic mobility for struggling households. That could include measures like expanding tax credits for low-income workers, deregulating industries to spur job growth and wage increases, or overhauling welfare programs to increase their effectiveness. Poverty is fundamentally a cash flow and behavioral issue in most cases, not just a lack of resources, said Riedel. "These inflationary checks provide temporary support but do little to address the bigger problems driving inequality, stagnant wages, and lack of skills and opportunity in too many communities." In response, Defenders of these $2,200 payments argue they put cash directly in the hands of those most likely to immediately spend it and stimulate economic growth from the bottom up, especially when the economy is veering closer to recession territory. Politically, the payments are also viewed as an easier sell than more transformative policy shifts that could be controversial or disrupt existing income support programs.